So, continuing on, you can see that if you think you know how monetary and fiscal policy work, then you know how to move the aggregate demand curve. And if you combine that with the knowledge of the Phillips curve, then it looks like policymakers, people running fiscal and monetary policy, now have a nice menu of choices. And in some ways, the Phillips curve does represent a menu of choices between two unpleasant things. We can either choose to be in a situation where we have high unemployment but low inflation, or the reverse, low unemployment and high inflation, or we can choose to be in the middle here. So it's a menu of choices between two problems. And you can see how this would make people very confident that they knew how to understand the economy and they knew how to steer the economy where they wanted it to go. And the generation, of course, that invented the Phillips curve was the generation who had lived through the Great Depression, and either as children or as adults. And sort of not surprisingly, they sort of thought, well, if we're going to have a menu of choices between these two problems, we've seen how bad the danger of the economy going into a really severe recession is. So they were a little bit more likely to say, okay, let's make sure that we try to push unemployment down, because unemployment and recession is sort of the bigger danger relative to inflation. And sort of this is the situation that people are in going into, say, the late 50s and early 60s. There's this sort of thought that we should err on the side of stimulating the economy because it's better to overstimulate the economy. Maybe even a thought that the economy has some sort of inherent bias towards going into a recession if we don't stimulate it. But it's worth going and thinking through how this might all play out. So remember that in our aggregate demand, aggregate supply model, where we have prices, we have GDP, and we have a short-run aggregate supply curve, we think that eventually, if we shift from A to B because of an increase in aggregate demand, eventually, the short-run aggregate supply curve will start to shift left. As firms start to adjust this increased price level into their expectations of price and wage setting. So eventually, at some point here, we're going to end up with short-run aggregate supply curve 5, and that's going to put us back at our Goldilocks point here. Well, what does that look like in Phillips curve language? In Phillips curve language, what we're saying here is that we can move from A to B along the Phillips curve, but then there are forces in the economy which are going to cause further inflation and cause GDP to go back to its normal level. And if GDP goes back to its normal level, then unemployment goes back to its normal level. So a point like Z up here in this diagram corresponds to a point like Z in this diagram down here, because we have yet higher price level. So maybe actually it should be over here. But the important point here is that GDP has returned to its natural rate, and so has the unemployment rate. So this straight line I've drawn here is what we call the long-run Phillips curve. So the long-run Phillips curve, we think, is vertical at the natural rate of unemployment, or NARU, because in the long run, this is a real economic variable. And we think that nominal variables like inflation don't influence real economic variables like the unemployment rate in the long run. So that's essentially what this vertical long-run Phillips curve represents. The short-run Phillips curve has this downward slope. So that's why we think that in the short run, there is a trade-off between unemployment and inflation. The policies that will tend to push down unemployment will tend to push inflation up. The policies that will tend to push down inflation will tend to push unemployment up. But in the long run, there is no trade-off. Because in the long run, we always come back to Nehru. So, one way of thinking about this is, in the long run, the short-run Phillips curve shifts. And in particular, while a movement in aggregate demand caused a movement along a fixed short-run Phillips curve, a movement in short-run aggregate supply causes a shift of the whole Phillips curve. So there is no trade-off because short-run aggregate supply shifts, which causes a shift to a new short-run Phillips curve. So that's the essence there.